everyone hear me okay? Well, I'm Kirk Smith, like Lynn said. I'm a family medicine provider. Work over at Shared Medical Center in Alva. Currently, I'm based out of the urgent care, seeing patients for all the walk-in needs, as well as seeing regular kind of scheduled private practice patients over there that we do take care of currently in the urgent care until the office is done. Background-wise, I'm a board-certified family medicine doctor. So I see everything from prenatal care and newborns all the way up to geriatric care, nursing home age, and everything in between. So I'm able to go through and take care of everything for all your family needs that are there. The one thing, really why they brought me to this community that I do go through and offer, they haven't had since Dr. Burry left, is I do have that capability to go through and take care of our pediatric population in this town, which people have tried to fill in for a little while with between Dr. Kinsey and Dr. Colbert, however their background and training in adult medicine and what they do. They're just so happy and so much more comfortable going through and having someone who's actually trained to take care of children actually in this town to be able to care for the families in the community. Say otherwise, I went through and grew up in a suburb of Omaha, Nebraska, so I'm a lifelong Husker. This is a rough year. grew up there in part of Iowa, a suburb of Omaha, Nebraska. Eventually went down to University of Arizona for undergraduate. My undergraduate training, have a degree in biochemistry, worked for NASA when I was an undergrad. Following that, went back up to the upper Midwest and ran a research lab at the University of Iowa. University of Iowa for one doctor, and then for her husband out at MIT in Boston, kind of split time between the two locations, running research labs for them before I went to medical school. Went to medical school in Iowa, and then following that, ended up doing initial training in Kansas City, and then finished up residency training in the Tulsa area with the OU College of Medicine there. Following that training in family medicine, I actually did a fellowship in high-risk obstetrics. So previously I was in practice where I went through and delivered a large number of babies, where I've delivered in my career over 2,000 babies at this point. That is not something delivering babies that we'll go through and do in this community. It's a volume issue. And so it's one of those with the volume that we have in this community for people delivering babies, there's just not enough. The hospital would be losing incredible amounts of money to go through and do that. So for the volume that's here in this community, if we were to be delivering babies there, we'd probably be losing somewhere between $500,000 and $750,000 every year. That's something we're not going to go through and subsidize. We are going to bring back prenatal care, so a lot of those patients that currently that are pregnant that are having to drive to Enid for every single one of their visits, hopefully get most of their prenatal visits done locally until they're getting to the very tail end of their pregnancy, and then at that point they can start following with a delivery provider beyond the other end. That will be a helpful service to a lot of people that are here. So, otherwise, I'm one that I go through and do most everything. There's some people I've gone through and met here socially already. There's others that I've seen in the emergency room, whether it's caring for yourselves or caring for your family. I do go through and cover currently with the hospital, covering their emergency room at least 2 weekends a month. So it's something like this weekend coming up between 7 p.m. Friday and 7 a.m. Monday morning. They're in the emergency room going through and doing things. I will be there the entire time. We go through and work a bunch. So it's one of those where I'm just there to go through and take care of, you know, the entire family's needs for everything we have. As far as other things, I do have a background also in music where I went through and played professionally as a drummer in the past. I've played with people such as, I've played with Bobby Shue, Lionel Hampton, played with GRP All-Star Big Band, played with Dizzy Gillespie. Had a chance to go through and do a lot of those things. I used to on occasion have a chance when I was living over in the Tulsa area. Got to know Garth Brooks fairly well when he was still living over in that area as well, and kind of had a chance and carrying on there. Which actually kind of brings up one of those unique situations. Garth, if you've ever seen some of his shows, on occasion he'll sit there and when kind of between sets when they're slowing things down a little bit, just taking a little bit of that break. Sometimes he'll go through and he'll tell that little story of, you know, critics come in all shapes and sizes. Well, the background for a story, I was actually there when it happened. First marriage, I was there. My wife and I'd gone through and for a while had taken care of Garth's kids, and so got to know them fairly well. So we had one day where I'm actually hanging out over at Garth's house with him, and we're just hanging out down in the basement. My wife at the time, my two stepkids that were there, One of them is this 3-year-old that's running around. Garth's kids, at that time, they were about 8, 9, 10 years old, like showing off about their dad. Good guy to know it about. So they sit there and they start putting on one of his CDs, sitting there and playing one of his songs. You know, it happened to be I Got Friends in Low Places. My 3-year-old recognized the song, so she's there singing along with it. This is just hilarious to sit there and watch. So I mean, we sit there and we start laughing at this. It's just funny going through and doing it. She all of a sudden hears Garth and I sitting on this couch laughing. But it's not like it one bit. She sits there and just starts scowling at us. And right then we quiet up real quick. She forgets about us all of a sudden. She starts singing again. Yeah, Garth starts laughing. I mean, he just busts out laughing, falls down on the floor, and he's just kind of rolling around. This 3-year-old walks over to him and she goes, "No, no, no. It goes like this." I'm like, "Oh my God, cast me shot." But so if you ever go through and you've seen one of his shows where he slows down and he's telling that whole anecdote, yeah, that was my stepdaughter that did that. I was there telling Garth how to go through and sing a song. But I mean, otherwise, my wife Teresa, she's here with me. She's currently finishing up her master's in business administration. So her background's in business. She's worked with a lot of things in the past. She was a buyer with the Dillard's company previously, and was over a lot of the retail merchandise. Also for a while worked for a martial arts company and was in charge of several international warehouses, as well as most of their U.S. domestic supply for a lot of like the karate uniforms, some of the swords, some of the armory type things used in some of the martial art fields. When we left Oklahoma a couple years ago, we actually worked for a while with the Indian Health Service and with the federal government. And so we moved out, and we actually lived on an Indian reservation up at 7,000 feet elevation up in the mountains of New Mexico, just shy of the Colorado border. And that is a unique experience. So spent a couple years living out there. She didn't have any opportunities for a job as a white female living on an Indian reservation. There just isn't much there without a background in healthcare. And so she actually worked as a teacher in the schools there without any training. She started out as an educational assistant, and then they had one of their teachers leave mid-year, and so she actually had to become an everyday classroom teacher out on the Indian reservation. Found out that she loves working with people, but hates with passion going through and being that everyday teacher. It's one of those things that you find in life. What's your passion? What do you like? What do you not like? She thought it was something that she would enjoy. That is not something she liked at all. We eventually went through and moved from the Indian reservation, had that opportunity to come to Shattuck because they needed a provider there that could deliver babies. So we moved there. As that hospital was going through financial troubles, as many small hospitals are, they went through and shut down their OB and surgical units, and when they went through and did that, it basically eliminated the vast majority of our practice. And to be able to go through and remain viable, you know, we just kind of saw the writing on the wall and knew we needed to go through and relocate again. I'd had that opportunity while I was in Shattuck, however. I met Candace Allen, who's the CEO of the hospital here. She and I met out at some meetings out in San Diego last year. And as Candace and I went through and got to talking, went through and heard Dr. Bierig had left. They needed a provider. They needed someone that could do the full range family medicine. If I was also able to go through and cover emergency room services here, that would be an added benefit. It just happened to go through and sound like the perfect mix, so we went through and decided on pretty short notice, came here, and since that time, my wife, Teresa, and I, we've loved the community. I mean, this is one of those we've been welcomed with open arms everywhere we went. So we're here right now. We've been moved into town since the end of August. We are looking at various locations and things for hopefully buying land and building a house here and doing some other things, and have plans actually to go through and stay in this community long term. But that's one of those. I'm here, like I said, to go through and take care of your family and do things. Life and situations sometimes go through and change, and have people in different places and doing things other than what you anticipated at the time. My life has definitely had that in for me. But we're here, and like I say, our intention is to go through and be here for a very long time to come. So.
How old are your children now?
I have a son that went through and died previously, and then my daughter who lives over in Tulsa, she's going on 8 years old coming up. Yes, sir.
I missed the part about the office in the professional building.
The office in the professional building, we're going to be in Dr. Bierig's old space. And they have that space renovated, and it's actually ready to go at, as of this time. We were going to move there at the beginning of December. We're having to delay that for a short period. One of the insurance companies, Blue Cross Blue Shield, they haven't gone through and certified that as a new practice location for us yet. So until they credential us to be operating at that site, we can't get paid for anything we go through and do there for all our Blue Cross Blue Shield patients. So just to make sure that patients aren't stuck in kind of a little snafu in a catch-22 situation, we've delayed going through and opening our practice down there until they can get everything finalized with Blue Cross Blue Shield so the patients don't suddenly get stuck with the bill or the hospital isn't paid for services that we're providing.
Who is it that takes care of finalizing that information?
The administration from the hospital, they're very actively involved in it. We have a representative that with Blue Cross Blue Shield that represents the hospital, who is basically our advocate for Blue Cross Blue Shield, and that's the person that they're trying to really get moved to help get a lot of this done quicker. We can only move as quickly as Blue Cross Blue Shield will allow us to go. So right now we're dependent on them, but they are going through and contacting them every day, looking for status updates. There's a possibility we could be at our new location as soon as the middle part of this month. It may be the beginning of January. It could be the middle of January. It could even be February. Right now, we're just taking it on a day-by-day situation.
I heard something the other day that the Shattuck Hospital may have to close.
That is a distinct possibility. And that's one of the problems we had. And a good piece of the advice that we got from the CEO out there, which when they were shutting down some of their other units, they had already gone through from the time when I was still there and practicing. They probably reduced the size of their staff by at least 50%. And at that point, the CEO had said, you know, we run a serious risk if we go through and keep a couple of physicians who don't have full practices at this point that we have employed. By keeping people on staff, he let us know they were running the risk of actually bouncing checks to us. So that is one of those things that actually helped very easily make up our minds that it was time to move on to the next community. I work hard for a living, I love what I go through and do, but like most people, you do some things for charity, but I'm not going to do it for free all day long.
There's several kind of entities up there at the hospital. Like, if somebody wanted to come and see you, who did they call?
There's a couple different ways. Currently, until our new location opens, I'm based every day of the week, Monday through Friday, out of the urgent care facility. And so I have people that already go through and call to the urgent care. They have scheduled appointments that they come see me at certain times as convenient for them. As soon as our new location opens, we have a stack of cards that actually has our new office location address as well as phone number on there. Of course, we planned on being there as of yesterday. Like I said, we could be there 10 days from now. It may be 3 weeks. It may be 2 months. We don't know. We're at the mercy of Blue Cross Blue Shield at this point. But as soon as we can go through and be there, we have contact information for our new office and where we will be. But in the meantime, urgent care is always, we take walk-in appointments, but I do have a number of people that, if they go through and call and ask to see me specifically, I have a lot of people that go through and schedule. Because we do have several internists in this town, and while myself, Dr. Kinsey, and Dr. Colford are all employed by the hospital, Dr. Self is also here, you know, is a wonderful member of the community, going through and doing a lot for the citizens of Alva. All three of them are internal medicine providers, which means, in general, by training, by what they do, they only see patients age 18 and older. I'm a family medicine doctor, so I see everything from birth through death and everything in between. And so that's the one thing where most of my practice will probably skew towards the younger patients and taking care of a lot of the younger families, just because I'm the only provider that takes care of the kids. But I take care of everyone. I have a number of patients I already go through and have seen a number of times that follow with me that are in their 90s. And we have quite a few that are in their 80s and 70s. We take care of everything. You know, but it is one as well. that it is nice for the older population in town that we do have three providers that specifically only see those age ranges. And so, you know, while I do want to go through and fill up and build practice and be successful, at the same point, we also want to utilize the other people that we have in this town that are here every day and going through to help other people as well.
And the appointments that are being made with you in urgent care, what age range are those appointments?
Everything. Yes, sir.
Every small town in Oklahoma, essentially with the hospitals, what people are doctors is like to do. What made you decide to come to Alva?
One, it was the right timing. Two, for us, it was the feel of the community. And the things all along that are most important to myself, to my wife, and Lauren. I can do a job anywhere. That part, you know, I'm flexible, and I can survive in about any community. What we care about is we want a good, strong school. We want a good, strong church. Those are the key criteria that we go through now in this town. Unfortunately, on our end, the schools are great. You know, we found that. Church-wise, I tend actually more over in Tulsa than I do in Alva. It happens right now where I'm working almost every other weekend in the emergency room. When I do cover our emergency room here, I have to be physically in the hospital. So like this weekend, I'll be in the hospital from 7 p.m. Monday night, or 7 p.m. Friday night, until actually about 5 or 6 p.m. on Monday evening when I finally go home. So this coming weekend, while I actually will be in town, unfortunately I can't sit there and attend one of the local churches because I'm actually working, you know, in the ER. Even if nothing's going on there right now, the way they have it, I can't actually sit there and escape, be down at one of the churches, know that I might get called out emergently, and then sit there and come over. I've had that arrangement with them at other hospitals in the past, at some small communities I've been at, where we could take some of that emergency room call even from outside, understanding that you may need to be back somewhere within 5 to 10 minutes. Right now, that's not the case here in town. You know, and so we still sit there, and because I do have a young daughter over in Tulsa, we still sit there and spend at least one weekend, if not 2 weekends a month in the Tulsa area. And so we're still very active in some of the churches there. Again, we care about community. We care about family. We want something that's go through and people can have a strong basis that they can go through and build your future. The fact that there's a college in town is a huge boost. It's one of those things my wife absolutely is thrilled with. You know, that education is valued. That you can go through, you have a system in place potentially to go through and train leaders and keep leaders in town compared to a lot of small towns where your best and brightest are going to go elsewhere. You don't have anything to go through and keep them. There are some mechanisms, there are some things to be able to go through and keep people in town. And that's one of those things, especially for communities this size, that you always have to go through and look at. What can we create for industry, for innovation? What can we go through and do to keep some of those best and brightest here to make this a thriving area versus we're dependent only on, you know, the oil fields and what happens there.
Thank you.
You know, kind of along with that, there's one of the questions I went through and got asked when I remember it was actually when I interviewed out Shattuck for a position. And he came there, one of their hospital board members, he said. And he said, now at the end of your career, he said, tell me, are we supposed to name the gym or the auditorium after? You know, that's perfect. Establish a legacy. You know, and that's what you want to go through and do is that you're there, you're establishing that legacy, and you're making that difference in people's lives. And so, I mean, truly, if you're taking that long-range approach and you're thinking about it in those terms, absolutely. Right now we've gone through and we found things, especially where I have that niche, if I can provide something that others in town can't, that makes it a wonderful thing for us to try and grow. You know, like I said, we're actively looking at plots of land for one, building our home, also for some land adjacent to it for potential pasture land and being able to go through and do things. And we'd love to be able to get back to that point again where we're building our house, we're building our barn, we're having area for horses, we have area to go through and potentially even if we need to, having a few cattle, you know, being able to plant alfalfa, do a few other things. It's an area we love. It's most of the things, you know, it's what warms your heart, it's what goes through and brings you passion. You know, we love the rodeo environment. You know, my wife grew up in the San Diego area, and she'd always gone through, for the most part, really lived in cities. That's one of those things as we've gotten to some of the smaller areas. she realizes how much she loves a lot of those things. And while she's an outdoor person, we loved hiking when we lived up in the mountains. While the scenery may be a little bit different, you find those things that you love and you have a passion for. The same sort of thing we go through and we stress towards the students. What goes through warms your heart and drives you a lot of times. If you have that passion with what you go through and do, that's a wonderful thing and it's going to keep you going. You know, when you're going through and you're looking for a profession, if you can sit there and do something to follow those passions versus going to a job, it's amazing going to work every day to go to help people. I love what I do. I have a passion for helping people. Sometimes I spend too long in the patient rooms because we're sitting there, we're educating patients, we're educating families. You know, we're trying to go through and just be able to go through and get in there and make that connection. As we go through and get more and more patients and build up, we don't get as much time to spend doing some of those personal things. You know, but that's what we go through and do on a daily basis. My job is to go through and help them. You know, I am a servant. That is what I go through and do. You know, people go through for the most time when they go through and come up and ask. Unfortunately, a lot of times when they say, you know, hi, how are you? You know, how do you go through and define yourself? Well, yes, well, I am a physician. Well, yes, I'm a father. I'm a husband. You know, you break it down, I'm a child of God. That's baseline. That's who I am. You know, I go through and I have one master that I follow. I have one Lord and Savior. And all that I can go through and do to honor Him, you know, and use those talents, I can use those abilities that I've been given, that I've been granted, and use those to help serve others.